Welcome back to Proactive London. I'm joined by Barry Shia from Xiao-i Corp. Barry, very good to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you, Stefan.
So Barry, for those viewers not familiar with the company, can you tell us a little bit about Xiao-i Corp?
Definitely. Xiao-i was actually a very unique company that it listed on NASDAQ. Actually, our company was formed in 2001 that we firmly deepened our business in cognitive AI. That means we've been rooted our business in cognitive AI for 20 years. And we have firmly rooted our ambition to leverage our AI technology and empower the whole society with better lives and fulfill their dreams. So we are the pioneer of the chatbots. You know, in 2004, we launched the chatbot on MSN, which is Microsoft application. And soon in 2008, the active user has breached 100 million. And after that, in 2011, with the mindset of fulfilling our missions, we adjust our strategy and focus on a B2B market with applications and dig deep in our client usage scenarios and develop the suitable AI solutions for our clients. And then we find an interesting phenomenon that although the developed areas are leading R&D power of the AI technologies, but there are normally lack of the applications. So globalization became our important strategy since 2018. And we start from Hong Kong, Taiwan, and then Macau. We leverage on our multi-language AI solutions. We build up several pilots and got recognized by enterprises and government locally. And then this year, we successfully listed on NASDAQ, and we introduced our large language model, Hua Zang. And we expand our very first footprint into US with our new subsidiary of US branch. So that is only a brief introduction. And just a quick aside, you know, 7 years, as I previously introduced, we invented the chatbot on MSN in 2008. And only 7 years later, Apple introduced Siri, which is intrinsically an identical product like Xiao-i's chatbots.
You mentioned listing on NASDAQ. Was that part of your globalization strategy? And what sort of reception have you had from US investors?
Actually, you see that we consider listing on NASDAQ is a very good way for us to demonstrate our brand and demonstrate our power as well as the quality of our service to our potential clients. And also we consider AI as a technology. There's no boundaries within a country. We want to leverage on our AI technology to empower the society as well as our client with better applications and to make sure they live a better life.
Okay. I mean, you were out with your first half results recently, and net revenues more than doubled, up 106% to all-time highs. And I suppose really being driven by, first of all, your cloud platform, but just also the huge momentum we've seen in AI this year.
Yes, definitely. You see, it was largely related on our business model shift, considering, you know, in China, the software, the AI technologies are used to deliver it in terms of the software services. So the business model was much more like we deliver a software to our client, and that is once-time delivery, and that's for all. Maybe 5 or 6 years later, they will come to us and to purchase another one. So you see this kind of business model is not so good, and it has lower client loyalty and doesn't expand to a larger economic scale. So in last year, we started to educate our client to transform slowly from the once-off delivery into the subscription upon our cloud services. So this kind of transformation was actually strongly support by the development of our product. We developed this model-like product to make sure that our AI technologies can evolving and spontaneously based on our upgrade of the product. Our client, if they do the subscription, they can be benefiting based on every spontaneous upgrades monthly or quarterly or yearly. So that our clients are slowly transforming from the software once-off deliveries of the software to the on-cloud subscription. That means not only the original clients' revenue will be increasing, and their stickiness of our clients is also increasing. And not to mention, considering there's upgrade upon their services, it's easily for us to ask for the premium upon the same services. So that there's actually not only the delivery units has been increasing, but also the average selling price for this kind of services is increasing as well. So switching from this once-off delivery of these softwares to the on-cloud services is a better business model for us, and also a more healthier, a sustainable business model for the whole industry.
With generative AI triggering a new technological revolution, how is Xiao-i positioned for that?
We position ourselves to be the operation system in the AI era. You see, ChatGPT is a very great interface. It's this kind of technology or this kind of product is more like a super interface compared to the previous version. You see, the whole AI industry has been evolving in the last several tens of the decades. You see, at the very first beginning, there was rule-based AI solutions, and then there's expert systems, and then it's evolving into machine learning, and then now is the series of the large language models, which is ChatGPT version. So in every different version of the AI, it creates different interfaces. For example, last series of the AI solutions is the version of Siri, and we see the Siri application everywhere. When you order, you book a ticket, airline ticket, there's automatic customer service is answering your questions, and that is supported by the version of Siri. But that is only vocal, and their responding is not so human. You can easily differentiate the AI from the human. But when it's evolving into the ChatGPT version, the feedback from the AI is much more human-like. They can understand your feelings, and they can calculate and find the best responding to you. And also, they can even make some they can make some decisions for you to optimize your decisions for you. So the large language model is actually a verbal version of the interfaces. Humans are communicated based on verbal, so it's the best way of the interfaces to as the interfaces to do the application. So we position ourselves to be the operation system of the AI era, and then we wanted to leverage on our clients base, and then combine with our AI technologies to form a platform to educate our client to develop their own application based on our large language model operation system. So we can elaborate later for the details, but that will be a briefly answer to your question.
Well, thanks very much for all that. I hope you will keep us posted on any progress you make. Thank you very much for the introduction today.
Yeah, thank you. Let's keep in touch.
That's Barry Xia from the Xiao-i Corp.